Alive Festival, 2006. The Alive Festival is an event that is designed to bring Christian youth back to the element. Much like the days of campfires and singing Kumbaya, kids gather in small groups to worship Jesus. This year, the youth of Harvest Point, led by two spiritual yet energetic youth pastors, wanted to get in touch with the elements, worship in small groups, and participate in traditional music by worshiping the Lord. Alive 06. What an experience.
What an experience.
What an experience.
What an experience.
God's in this fight, you can like it or not. So rip the knob off the volume when you give it a shot. Raise your hands as the slam starts to thicken the plot. Open your eyes to the lies of the enemy's lie. So run like the wind from the sin of your past. Keep your eyes on the prize when they put you on blast. It's the Christ of the cross, it's humanity shot. It's a worldwide call to everything that we're not.
This is the slam.
Take me to your throne.
Billy made a promise
but didn't end though. Carrie had a dream, but she threw it out the window. Kevin met a nice girl who broke his heart, and his friends never told him, but they knew it from the start. And these are the things we go through. Let's take control and be ourselves. Let's not waste time wondering about how we're gonna make it out. Go! Wake up, everyone around you. Let's rock until the clock strikes two. Stand up for what you believe and shout to. Here's another song from the youth that surround you. Wake up, everyone around you. Let's rock until the clock strikes two. Stand up for what you believe and shout to. Here's another song from the youth that surround you.
I wanted to come to Alive because I figured it'd be a great way to rekindle that fire that I knew was in there. Because lately I've just been getting beaten down a little bit, you know, school, work, gone in mowing grass, just it's getting to me. And I was pretty much at a low point. So I wanted to come here, get back up on that high horse, you know, and just start rolling again. Because I know everything was going to be awesome someday. And this kind of thing will just really help us get there faster, you know.
I wanted to come to Alive because I wanted to get closer to God in my Christian walk and meet new people that are as hyped up as I am about God and the church.
I wanted to come to Alive because I love music and I love praising the Lord. And this way I can do it both. And I saw how all the groups and stuff were just so refueled. And they were just so passionate about what they do, and I just knew it was going to be a ton of fun, and it was going to give me a chance to be with my friends and all that kind of stuff, so I thought I knew it was going to be a fun time.
The reason I wanted to come to Alive was basically just to get an experience in a safe environment where I can worship the way I wanted to with people that believe in the same way, or I guess not the same way, but believe in the same person that I do.
The reason why I wanted to come to Alive mainly was I hadn't been to many Christian concerts or concerts in general, and I really wanted to see what that was like. Also, the atmosphere here, I wanted to see what it was like as well. I've learned a lot from that, and it's been a great experience so far, so I'm glad I came.
I wanted to come to Alive because I thought it would bring me closer to the church.
I wanted to come to Alive to just experience just being with kids, and really initially found myself wanting to get our youth involved with being with other people, developing relationships with people in their community, and just bringing that to the trip. I found myself really being refreshed myself with the worship and hearing the bands and letting the leg of the Holy Spirit just work in the community of our youth group, and really trying to help us to connect. So I think we all need people to connect, and it helps us just to get away. So a lot of hand offering that to allow us to connect to one another.
Hello, welcome to Alive 06. I'm at Ryan Forrest's house. Let the party begin.
Where are the chairs of fire at, seriously?
Yeah.
At least it would be one more than two passengers in.
Ben!
Yeah, what's up? You should zoom in really close, dude.
Are you
zooming in
right
now?
Shot right there.
Aw, yeah. I can't tell what it is.
Wait.
Okay. You can't even see it, right? Yeah, zoom out a little bit here. Come on now.
Can't see how I'm zoomed. And.
Woo!
Hi, Mark.
Yeah, it's really close to Lauren's head.
Yeah, creepy.
There's Corey and Tori. Tori and Corey.
Oh, they're
like
Ryan.
They're like an 80s or a 70s group.
I was just doing 80s, yeah.
Tori and Corey.
And then there's Tyler.
And then there's Beck.
Amanda is 12,
no,
but she will be 13-ish.
No, I'm not. She's gonna be 15.
or 15. She's young.
You failure.
It doesn't matter.
12 to me.
And then there's Kayla, and she's my.
And then here's Kayla. The weird thing on Corey's lip. I'm not sure what it is. It may move. We think it's a caterpillar, but we're not sure. If he sneezes butterflies, we know what it is.
Nice.
And there's the Jared can.
Oh, yeah.
And a little Ryan can.
Wait.
What
about the snod can?
Hang on. Gotta get a little Ryan cam.
Oh, yeah. We got Ryan cam going. Okay. Oh, look at him drive. He's so focused. That's awesome.
Virginia has to be dashboard cam. And there's the snod cam.
There's the snod cam. Yeah. Woo! Okay.
On this trip, I learned that it doesn't matter who you're with, or if you know the people or not, because you can just praise however you want to praise. You know, if praise and worship's not your thing, then you can just go talk to some people. I mean, you don't gotta do what everybody else is doing. We're gonna do that Harvest Point, because some people aren't the praise and worship people. Some people would rather talk to you and have a big, deep conversation. And we gotta accommodate all people. That's what we're gonna do.
I've learned that God will accept, or God will forgive you no matter what you've done, and He'll always take you back. And I'll use that in our church by helping people get through their problems and stuff like that.
I've learned not to let the little things bother you. This, like Colin Barnes did, just wipe the dust from your feet, let things go, and just keep moving on with your life.
One thing I've learned is not take everything at face value and not take for granted what I have. I guess just cut loose from worshiping the way I'm supposed to, not the way that I hold to. That's a big way of putting it. Make it a more relaxed environment. I guess make it more inviting to people that I guess converse with every day. Make it feel like Christianity isn't a routine or it isn't a synchronized worship time. It's just where you cut loose and you do what you feel.
Okay. What I really learned this week, it was more of a relearning than a learning. I kind of learned how to be a servant again. This week was a really, the weather this week was really kind of a rainy, muddy week, and we had many chances to help people out that needed help, and our youth group was one of those that was quick to respond to that, and I kind of relearned how to not be selfish and be like, oh, I'm going to get muddy, and just go after it and help other people. They were really gratified with that, and one thing I could really do is help do that in our community in Greenwood, and at a Harvest Point, I could be bold and step up and help people when they need that. So that is one thing I can do to help our community.
We were challenged to spread joy and just randomly go up to people and say hi and stuff. And I think by doing that, then we could bring more people into our church and stuff. I have learned that you can worship in many different ways, through prayer, through song, through just talking. I have many friends that think that Christians just pray all the time and just that's how they worship, and that's not true. The music was, you have contemporary and you have rock, hard rock. It's awesome. So I'm going to try to tell people that there's many different ways to worship.
I think one thing I learned from this trip is to really let God be in control, you know, just to let the Holy Spirit work. I see many kids be moved not only just through the worship and the concerts, I mean, that's kind of a given, but you know, one-on-one conversations and the prayer times, you know, that there's no, it doesn't always need to be an agenda, but there doesn't always need to be a program. Those are great. Those things can, you know, be there for tools and guidance, but you know, a lot of times, you know, if you let God work, if you let God be in control, you know, He's going to overwhelm us and really just inspire us, you know, through the Holy Spirit. That's kind of what we were talking about this week, was to, you know, allow the Holy Spirit to work, to let Him, you know, let the Holy Spirit just fill you and just be a part of your relationship and help us grow. A lot of teens, and myself included, excuse me, really got that this week. Just to spread the joy and just to let Him work our lives.
My most memorable moment is when I looked out. See the kind of people we had behind us during the concert, and it's just everybody. Everything I can see is full of people who want to praise God. I don't know how many, probably hundreds of thousands of people there for the same reason, to grow. And I want to be part of it. And I want to remember that for next year.
My most memorable moment was when Chris Tomlin came out and he had us all join hands and we all started jumping up and down. I felt like a lot of people were there. Well, all the people were there because of the same reasons that I work, and we all love God. It made me feel happy.
Good.
My most memorable moment is when all the guys in the group were out helping push cars out of the mud, and we had probably at least 2 inches of mud on our legs, so at least.
Playing in the mud, digging a trench, watching all of our guys, and occasionally helping move cars. But the most memorable, I think, was when we listened to our speakers at our seminars, Justin Lukidu. He kind of, as the little lip says, he'll put it right in your face, and you're kind of like, why didn't I see that? And he does. He opens your eyes to what's really going on, and even though you're not willing to accept it, it's kind of like,
I think the most memorable moment so far this week has been the bus rides to places. We've had a couple great adventures so far. We've had bus problems, breakdowns, detours. it's been a great time. It's not really something I'm really stressed over. Everybody kept a positive attitude, and we made the best of it, and I think that was probably the funnest time so far this week.
Well, first one was Reliant K. I got to sit in the front row, and could have sworn that the lead singer kept looking at me. And then I started freaking out when Mark Nelson came on the stage, and it was kind of scary. And then I had this poster for Mark Nelson, and a guy read it in front of like 50,000 people or stuff. And then Jason, the lead singer of Mark Nelson, he saw my poster, and he pointed and waved at me. And when I met Hawk Nelson, we talked a lot, it was cool. And then Jason, he held my hand for something. And then the guy that was wearing cutlass, he threw his water bottle and it got me wet. So it was pretty awesome. And then I was eating lunch and I was facing this door, and then I just took a bite of my sandwich, and all of a sudden, Daniel from Mark Nelson walks out in front of me, and I just watched him go by, and he just smiled,
And then I was freaking out, and then all of a sudden Aaron, the drummer, he came out. He didn't look at me, but he went back in. And then Daniel came back out, and we asked him if I could get a picture with him. So he was eating ice cream, and we got a picture together. And then he went back inside, and then Jason came out. And he smiled and waved and stuff.
What is your most memorable moment so far?
My most memorable moment is when the van broke down at this pizza parlor, and I really had to use the bathroom like really bad. So the pizza parlor only has one bathroom. It's this little family owned. So I go to the bathroom and it overflows when I flush it. It was great. I start crying because it's going out the door into the kitchen, and I'm like saying I'm sorry, crying. They're like, it's okay, it's just the water, but that, it was great. My most embarrassing moment ever. Never had one. That was it.
Oh gosh, I think this is probably everybody's most memorable day. I have a lot of them, but probably the main one was Thursday and Friday night. Harvest Point team pushing the vans out of the mud, and all the cars, rained. Ever since we got here on Wednesday was a pretty good day. Thursday just poured, Thursday and Friday. It was just a muddy mess. And, all the cars in the parking lot in the grass. We ended up at the concert, especially Thursday, started walking to our van, and, a lot of people were getting stuck. And, the guys just chipped in, and even the girls, got behind some vehicles, and we just started pushing, helping get out, really doing some service. It's kind of more fun for us just to hang out, know that we're helping people, having fun with it too. So, it allowed us to get take our shirts off, and show our bodies, how strong I am, how bold I am, and I've been working out. And it allowed me to, showcase my body and get some mud on me. So you don't have to use that if you don't want to. No, it was just a fun time getting money, and it's a great time. So that's my most memorable moment, helping those out of troubled deep trenches of mud.
There's a close-up of his toe ring.
Oh, we should probably let this guy through.
Oh my gosh, he has some major fungus going on. Look at
that. We should probably let him through. He has a nice pause.